tech geeks and wannabe tech geeks out there. My name is Robert Heidel. Today we're going to talk about cooling options for your PC. There are two types of people that this presentation is intended for. Those who are interested in building a custom PC, and those who experience overheating problems and want a more viable solution other than cooling fans. There are many different cooling options, but today we're going to concentrate on the two most popular. Air-cooled systems using heat sinks, and liquid-cooled systems using water to cool your PC. If you notice in this diagram of the heatsink system, the CPU sits at the bottom with the heatsink directly on top. Now that allows the heatsink to extract the heat from the CPU and to dissipate it through the CPU fan. And with proper airflow, that heated air could actually go right out the case fan. And this is actually a diagram of the proper airflow. Notice that the front of the computer takes in all the cool air and it's dissipated through the back, the top, and even the sides of the computer. My computer actually has a side fan. Moving on to the liquid cooler system, the diagram here, you see the CPU at the bottom with the water block directly on top. The water block actually stores the water. The heated water then gets pumped into the reservoir, which then gets pumped into the radiator, cooling the water with the help of the cooling fans, and then the cool water gets pumped right back into the water block in a constant cycle. Now we're going to talk about the reliability of the heatsink versus the liquid cooling system. I've actually devised this table to point out the pros and cons between the heatsink versus the liquid cooling system. Some of the pros for the heatsink include it's actually safer for the computer parts, meaning that in contrast to the liquid cooling system, there's no leakage, there's no water spills or anything like that, so it's much safer for the other components. It's much easier installation. It is actually way cheaper than a liquid cooling system. It's highly reliable, and it is relatively inexpensive. Some of the cons include the heat can be dissipated to other components if there's not proper airflow. If you notice in the diagram before, I demonstrated the proper airflow and the reason why it's important for that proper airflow. Moving on to the thermal paste application, this is actually a pretty tricky application if you don't know what you're doing. The idea is to get a very thin layer of the thermal paste on the CPU plate so that when you set the heatsink plate on top, you can actually wiggle it just a little bit to try to put an even coat. And the reason why that's important is because you don't want to have any air bubbles in between the heatsink and the CPU. If that happens, you would actually overheat the CPU unexpectedly and sometimes unknowingly. So it's very important to apply that on. And if you feel like you messed up the application, all you have to do is take the heatsink back off, wipe off the thermal paste for both the heatsink and the CPU, and reapply and try again. So it's relatively inexpensive. If you think you messed up, just keep doing it over and over until you think you've got it right. Also, the last con, finally, the heatsink needs more fans. So I suggest having at least two case fans. And you really don't need too much more than that unless you're an avid gamer, you're a hardcore gamer. Hardcore gamers, I suggest having at least three fans. And the reason why you don't need more than two fans with the heatsink is because generally the other components in the computer have their own fans or heatsinks built in. So they're pretty protected. That heatsink just helps to work for your CPU. I personally have a heatsink on my CPU and my video card, so it actually helps out greatly with my airflow and keeping my components very low heated. Moving on to the liquid cooling system, we have the pros, which are which include it cools more efficiently than the heatsinks do. It obviously looks cooler, so you know you can actually show off your cool liquid cooling systems to some of your geek friends. And it also needs fewer fans. The reason why, because it's an internal cooling system with the water. I've showed you the diagram how it works. So you notice that, you know, it's a constant cycle. So you don't need a lot of fans to exude all that heat out of the computer. You just need one to two fans, really, and you should be good. And some of the cons include that it's actually dangerous for other computer parts and their